You know, often it's very difficult for us to sort out which voices we should be following in life. If we don't get this right, we will find ourselves on the opposing side of what God's will is for us. We see this warned in James chapter 4, and he says, "Don't you know that friendship with the world is enmity with God? Therefore, whoever wishes to be a friend of the world makes himself an enemy of God." I have to define a term here, though, because when the Bible talks about the world, it's not just talking about the people in it or the environment that we live in. It's talking about the system that opposes the will of God. It's the thought process that puts man at the pinnacle of all things true and all things pleasurable, and it removes or seeks to dismiss the voice or the will of God. And so James is warning that if that's the side you want to link up with, if that's who you want to count as friends, just check this off in your mind that you will be in opposition to the Lord. He says, "Or do you suppose it is of no purpose that the scripture says that he yearns jealously over the spirit that he has made to dwell in us?" In other words, God planted within us his Holy Spirit. He gives us his very presence, and as we drag it into the systems of the world, as we drag it through, not just the activities, though the activities are a big part of this system, but also through the philosophies, through the coachings, if you will, of the direction for our life, he says, "I yearn jealously for the spirit that I put within you. I won't just allow that to continue." That's why he actively opposes the proud. And we know that it's the proud person who says, "I can do this without God." So this is the warning that comes from James. This is the reason why we need to be on the alert as to who our alliances are being formed with, who our allegiances are to. This is the encouragement from James chapter 4 for today. God bless you.